Robinhood is one of the largest investing apps in the world with over 13 million users. This is the app which kind of launched the next generation of investing apps that we see popping up all over the place today. In this video, I'm going to be walking through the app, showing you its different features, talking about the different ways that you can use it, and also getting into some background on Robinhood as a company and how they actually make money. This video is made in partnership with MoneyMade.io, which is a platform that lets you discover, learn about, and invest in different types of investments. There will be a link in the description if you want to check them out. With that, let's jump right into Robinhood. When you first open Robinhood, you're immediately greeted by the investing tab, which shows how much money you have invested in the upper left-hand corner. You can see I don't have any right now. On this page, you can create these different lists of stocks that you want to track. So for example, it creates one automatically for you called My First List, and in here it's tracking Apple, Twitter, Tesla, Netflix, as well as how much these stocks have gone up or down in the last day. In addition to just these basic stock lists, you can also create lists of different kinds of securities, so for example, crypto. This one right here is tracking both Dogecoin and Bitcoin. And then you can also create your own list just by hitting the Create New List button here. Name it whatever you want. Let's call it My Third List. And then you can add whatever assets you want here. So let's say I wanted to add Bitcoin in here. I could add that. Or if I wanted to add Apple, I could add that too. And then when I go back to the main screen, it'll track both of those for me. You can also add funds to your account through this page just by clicking Add Funds Now, and then it'll pull funds automatically from your bank account. Now it uses a third-party service to do this called Plaid, and that service also supports some companies like Venmo and American Express. So that's pretty much it for the investing tab, and you can see at the bottom of the screen here, there's five different tabs that you can go to in the Robinhood app. So let's go to the next tab, which is the Cash Management tab. This part of the app basically acts like a checking account. You can put money into this account just like you would with a normal bank, and Robinhood will pay you 0.3% APY. This is obviously lower than you could get on a traditional savings account, but it's probably higher than most checking accounts are going to give you, so you have to weigh the benefits there. One change to this account, which did not exist before on Robinhood, is this account is now FDIC insured, which means that up to $250,000 of cash held in this account would be covered by the FDIC in case of some kind of loss. They talk about a couple other benefits here, like there's some ATMs that you can use, and then they also have a debit card which they can issue to you from Sutton Bank. This is very similar to the cash management in some other apps, including M1 Finance. And like those other apps, you're gonna have to make your own choice of whether or not this account is worth it for you. In general, you can find better services for all these different areas. For example, you can find better cards than this. You can find better interest rates than this, but you might not find them all in the same place as your brokerage. So if you think it's worth the convenience of having it there, it could be a good feature for you. So next, let's move to the browse section of this app, which is this little search icon here. On this tab, you'll have a bunch of different news stories that you can look at, which either talk about individual stocks or just the market in general. For example, right now it's talking a bunch about GameStop because that's big in the news. And then you can also see what companies have been moving the most today. So these companies here are the ones that have gone up either the most or the least in the last trading day. The other nice thing about this tab here is you have these popular lists that you can look up. So for example, if I wanted to look up technology stocks, I can hit that here. And it takes me to this pre-populated list of stocks so I can see what companies, I guess, are doing in that area. I can see this being useful if you're just first getting into stock investing and you don't really know what kind of companies you're looking for. This could maybe give you some good ideas. But once you have your basic investments already established, I don't see too many people probably going and trying to discover stocks this way. So the other part of this tab here is this search functionality where you can look up specific companies based on either their name or their stock symbol. So let's say that I was investing in Apple and I wanted to look up information on that company. I could search them here, open them up, and it'll show me their stock chart. It'll show me some of these statistics here, which may or may not be relevant depending what kind of investor you are. And then it'll give you a couple news articles on the different stocks, as well as these analyst ratings. Now, I personally wouldn't use most of this information because I like to invest in stocks looking at their financial metrics and not based on the news. For me personally, the bottom of this page is where I would actually get value, where we can see the different quarter earnings that Apple has reported. And then there's also this button to replay their last earnings call. Now, I've looked at this for a couple different stocks and the functionality here is a little bit inconsistent. So for Apple, you can see that this opens up a video which links back to Apple's actual Q1 financial reporting call, but let's say I did the same search for Tesla stock. So on Tesla stocks page, if I click replay earnings call, rather than taking me to an actual earnings call, they take me to this loading screen where it's clear that they cannot find the page that it was linked to before. It was probably removed. And then once this times out, it just refreshes and takes me to Tesla's home screen. So again, it's going to depend on what kind of investor you are. Me personally, I would probably not look up companies within the app. I would just go to Google and search what specific company I wanted to look up earnings for, just because the functionality is a little bit inconsistent within Robinhood. And then if you scroll down a little more, there's this about section, which gives a little blurb about the company's background. And I actually just learned Elon Musk's middle name. Elon Reeve Musk. And then obviously on this page, you can click trade if you want to buy into the stock, or you can click the check mark on the upper right corner to add this stock to a list. So the next screen here is the actual screen for buying or selling stocks. You have to access this by going to the individual stocks within Robinhood. So if I click trade and then I click buy here, I can enter the dollar amount of Tesla I want to buy, and Robinhood will automatically buy that number of shares converted to dollars. Now, normally this wouldn't be possible because shares aren't worth exactly $1, but Robinhood provides fractional shares, meaning that let's say a share costs $100. You could, instead of buying one share for $100, buy half a share for $50. Additionally, if you don't want to use that, you can use this dropdown to switch from dollars to a different kind of order. So for example, I could buy in shares instead. You can also use some pretty traditional brokerage conditional orders here. So for example, you could make a recurring investment in Tesla, and you can also set limit or stop orders for your buying and selling. One other type of trading you can do with Robinhood is buy options. Now, you have to be approved to do this, but it is ridiculously easy to get approved. It's basically impossible not to be approved. So if you click trade and click trade options, they will actually teach you what a call and a put are on the first page of the options screen. So clearly they're not appealing to people who have a ton of experience investing in options. Now, if you're not aware, options are basically a way to bet on the price of a stock moving either up or down. You can sell a contract for a stock which says that you will purchase it at a given price or you will sell it at a given price. Now, because these contracts are much cheaper than the price of the actual stock, you can effectively take your money and leverage it to a huge scale. So for example, with $100, you could control 100 shares of stock if each contract only costs $1. This means that your potential upside is much higher, but also your potential downside can also be substantially higher, which is why I say they're more risky. The fact that Robinhood makes buying and selling options so easily could partly explain why their users on average trade 88 times more options than Charles Schwab users with the same amount of money. They basically made the friction as low as possible for trading options, even though these are a very risky investment. In addition to traditional stocks as well as options, you can also buy things like cryptocurrency in here. So if I were to open up Bitcoin, you can see here that there's a slightly different screen for buying and selling cryptocurrencies, but the functionality is basically the same. So after this, we can go back to the main screen, and the next tab to look at here is this messages tab. Now, this right here is basically just messages that Robinhood puts out, kind of like alerts. So for example, the most recent message that they've been pushing to me is the fact that they've been limiting the buying and selling of certain securities that have moved up and down a lot recently, mostly GameStop, and it's just basically their way of communicating with you. Now, finally, the last tab here is your user profile. On this page, you can see where your investments are actually kept. So for example, you can see what percent is in stocks, ETFs, options, crypto, and you can also, again, click these different links, which will show you, for example, ETFs. I could click real estate ETFs, and it'll give me a list of possible real estate ETFs that I could invest in. Kind of the same functionality that's elsewhere in the app, but here it's more in the context of your total portfolio. The last major part of this app is this menu, which is on the top right here, and it's a little bit out of the way. On this menu, you can basically control every aspect of your account. So for example, under investing, you can see your portfolio value, where everything's kept. You can see how much instant deposit cash you have available. Basically, if I transfer $1,000 to my Robinhood account, I can use that cash immediately, even if it hasn't actually cleared my bank account yet. Now, this limit will change somewhat if you have a gold subscription, but right now for me, the default is $1,000. Additionally, on this screen, you can set up your recurring investments. You can set up dividend reinvestment. You can also access your options here. So when I first signed up for the app, I actually had to come into this options selling area and take a quiz based on my previous experience of selling options. Based on what I told them, they gave me access to level 2 option trading, which gives you access to some options trades, but not buying or selling spreads. Now, if you don't want this limitation, it's super easy to circumvent. So for example, for me, if I wanted to enable spreads, I literally just click this button that says enable spreads, and I can upgrade to level 3 without doing any other kind of background check or research whatsoever. The one nice thing here is they'll give you a a crash course on what spreads are. It's definitely not going to be enough of an education to confidently invest in those areas, but at least you'll know what you're doing to some basic level. Also on here, you can track your day trades. Basically, Robinhood limits the amount of day trading that you can do on their platform. And the way they do that is this kind of health bar setup where if you day trade too often, you'll fill up your bars and you won't be able to do it anymore. Also in this menu, you can control your deposits as well as your transfers and your linked accounts. You can also look through your recent history of trades, as look at your tax documents, your account statements. You can also see your individual account settings. So your account information, your notifications, basically everything a normal app would have. And in here, you can also modify certain things like your account appearance. So right now my theme is just in light theme, but if I wanted to switch this to dark theme, I could do that right here as well. Now, last up, one thing which I haven't mentioned yet, I don't have the ability to buy on margin in my Robinhood account. And that's because I haven't yet signed up for a gold subscription. Robinhood Gold is basically their premier subscription service where you sign up to unlock the full features of the app. This includes trading on margin as well as a couple other benefits, including extra research and higher instant deposits. So Robinhood is a pretty full-featured brokerage. And in addition to the features that you can see, there's also some other features you get behind the scene. For example, the app is protected by the Securities Investor Protection Corporation, which will protect up to $500,000 in assets or $250,000 in cash. You also get their famous one free stock when you sign up, which is probably part of the reason why they've grown so quickly on social media from different people sharing their links to the Robinhood referral. So how then does Robinhood make money? Well, there's five basic ways that they make money. One is by earning interest off of the cash that you leave sitting in your account. Another is through their gold subscription program. They also make money off of margin interest and lending you money to buy stocks, and then they also make a large amount of money through directing order flow to certain high-frequency trading firms. Finally, they also make some money off of rebates. Now, the vast majority of Robinhood's income likely comes from directing their order flow to high-frequency trading firms, and I don't really have time to get into all that right now, but I do have another video on the topic if you're interested. So overall, Robinhood is a pretty full-featured investing app, and they continue to make changes as they've evolved. While the UI of the app is designed to reduce friction with users and make it easy for experienced investors to make trades, there's also the potential risk that newer investors can easily get in over their heads in options trading. Their sign-up bonus is also smaller than a lot of other brokerages, including Webull and M1 Finance, possibly because they already have such a good brand recognition, so they don't feel the need to push their affiliate program quite as aggressively. So let me know if you personally use Robinhood, and if there's any features that you would like to see added to Robinhood or just investing apps in general in the future. Make sure to like and subscribe if you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time.